Hello and welcome to Method Integration User Tutorials. This is part two of setting up method integration with QuickBooks. In the previous tutorial, we did 1 to 6 installation steps of connecting QuickBooks to our method account. And it's to the point where it's syncing. So let's continue from there. Oh, look. It says you can now use the method application and minimize the engine to let it finish running in the background. So if you want, instead of playing Minesweeper, you can go back and check out what we have. I know, I'm going to go and check to see what customers it has loaded up. Did it bring in any of my customers? Woo! Look at them all! Ha ha! So far, so good. It's still going. And I'm going to wait until it's done. Oh wait, maybe it is done. Did I just not pay attention? Okay, now that I got this up and going, I'm going to minimize this. Now, if at any point in time that you want to bring it back up again, you go over here, right click, and you can see display. And you can show this again, just to make sure if you want to disconnect, maybe you can synchronize, whatever. But that's how you can get it again. I'm going to minimize it. I guess I'm going to have to end my Minesweeper game. Now, what we need to do, and this is important, we're going to close our QuickBooks file. This is important. And we're going to reopen it just to make sure that the real-time synchronization is going to work for us. Let's do that. And while I wait, I can continue my game. Oh, I hate it when this happens. Which one? It's guessing. Guess. Ah, bother. Okay, now it's asking once again for the method integration listener for access. And just remember, hit yes always. That is what we want. And hit continue. Done. And we're good. We are connected to method. We can test that. I'm going to first go up to edit and take a look at the preferences. And I'm going to go to integrated applications. We're going to go to company preferences. And see these things here? This is the method integration, and this is the method integration engine listener. These two have to be checked. This is a means that it allows access. If for some reason you went and clicked no because you ignored my video, then you can go back into here and click yes, and then it will work. Sounds good? Let's do some testing. Let's add a customer. Let's go to customers. Let's just add one new customer. Let's just go ahead and put in company name. Oh, I don't know. Let's call it Discworld. And the full name, Terry Pratchett. Email, tp@discworld.com. That might be a real thing. Great. Now let's hit OK, and I added a customer. If I were to take a look at method, the display now, right clicking on that, I can see, entity addition to server. Let's go and check to see if that went over to method. And we can go to customer. We could do a search. Please work. There he is. Huzzah! It went through. All is well. And now to make sure that method can update QuickBooks, we're going to go to this contact, hit go to, and sadly, we're going to delete him. More actions, delete customer. Are you sure? Yes. I'll go and refresh that, and he's gone. Now let's go back to QuickBooks. We can see, one deletion from the server. All is well and good. So that means that if I were to search for Terry, he no longer exists in here. Now, before you're done, we do have step 7, where you repeat steps 2 through 6 for all other computers that access the same QuickBooks file. So if you have another computer with another employee that accesses the same QuickBooks file, you should do steps 2 through 6, where you install method on their computer. But remember, that's only if people are on QuickBooks and that needs to update method. If you want to access method, you can do that from anywhere, and you don't need to have a computer with QuickBooks on it. So if an employee is on QuickBooks, and you want it to update to Method, then you have to install the Method engine. However, if an employee is only accessing Method, then they can do that from any browser and from any computer, and it doesn't need QuickBooks. And that's it. We're done. You have connected your QuickBooks with Method. Thank you very much for joining us. If you have any questions, by all means, put them in the YouTube comments below, or you can tweet us at MethodCRM, and we will try to get to your questions. I hope this helped you, and have a great day. Bye-bye.